impressive and showing exactly why Maverick Vinales rates him so highly. So then now it's going to get busy. It's going to get frenetic and frantic at the end of this Moto3 Q2. We're into the final, what, 1 minute and 45 seconds. Just saw a lot of riders peeling out of the pit lane. Sergio Garcia, they're perfectly happy to do the work on his own here. Sixth place for him. Are we happy with that? A place on that second row. This man's looking for more as well. His teammate Tatay on pole is Martigas, who's trying to wrestle away that pole position. He's trying to make it what will be a dream 1-2 for the Seat Moto Racing Prudential GP team. Bit of a mouth comment we got there in the end.
A Chinese brand and motorcycle apparently is a big manufacturer. CF Moto.
Yeah, the CF Moto branded package, yeah. I'm sure there's a lot of Chinese people watching in this part of the world as well. Such popular sport, isn't it, in Southeast Asia? Yeah, the lap times. About 42.022 set by Tatay. Also over there from Tatay, wasn't there again? Coming through turn 16. Turn 2 and 16, Simon, are really, really tricky, aren't they?
Catching a lot of riders. It looks like they're trying to fight it to turn, and the front's just letting go right in the middle.
So a first 1:41 of the session comes in from the two teammates, Tatay and Artigas. They do take that CF Moto 1-2. Aji is still, as the clock ticks down to 30 seconds remaining on that front row, Foggia, who's picked himself up and picked that layer 500 after the spill at turn 2 a few months ago. What can Foggia do? This looks like it might be a front row. It is a 1:41.862. That pushes Aji off the front row. Aji himself, though, is on a decent lap, trying to get himself back into contention for that top three. A fourth place would still be a huge window for Aji in front of his home crowd. Now that we look back towards Adrian Fernandez, there's Sasaki getting a little bit of chatter, pushing the front tyre of that Husqvarna through the final corner. What can Sasaki do late on here? Over line he comes. He takes the checkered flag, the Japanese rider. Best he can hope for, that is eighth place. Ogju, the Turk, also took the checkered flag. He went up into sixth spot.
In the pole man, Tatay is on another one. Look, a couple of wins.
He was really a lucky Simon in Qatar. He had podium potential, no doubt about it. He's clicked with that CF Moto squad very, very quickly. Unfortunately, of course, he was involved in that very first lap incident with Garcia, which put Garcia through the long lap, sort of kicking Tatay while he was down. Garcia, of course, I mean, bumped him off, then went on to take a podium. Tatay, though, bouncing back impressively well here. There is Andre Minho, our world championship leader. He comes out the final corner, trying to pick up a bit of slipstream behind the rookie Ortola. Oh, he did brilliantly. Oh, Aji's gone on the front row, brilliant. We saw there quickly, Moreira's gone on the front row as well, the number 10 machine, just behind here. It was Ortola.